Speculations that Tesla's next dedicated production facility may be located in the United Kingdom have emerged once more, after the UK Minister of State for Business recently noted that the government is considering a site that will be able to sustain an excellent gigafactory. The area in question is dubbed Gravity, a 635-acre smart campus in Somerset, currently under development. While addressing Bridgewater and West Somerset MP Ian Liddell-Grainger in the House of Commons, Minister of State for Business Kwasi Kwarteng noted that he believes Somerset has the manufacturing skill and competence to be able to sustain an excellent gigafactory. Kwarteng also stated that the government is considering and looking at the site. In this video, we're going to be looking at how this site in the UK is set to boost production for Tesla and Elon Musk's plans for the gigafactory. Do watch this video until the end, and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Tesla Incorporated has received governmental approval to develop its massive gigafactory in southwest England to manufacture hybrid vehicles and batteries. Tesla is believed to have the manufacturing skill and competence to maintain an outstanding gigafactory, and the government is considering and searching for a location in the country. In the summer of 2020, Tesla CEO Elon Musk flew his private jet to Bristol to investigate new locations for the company's growth. The excellent Gravity site is supposedly one of the most substantial spots in the UK. It would eventually be known for the critical future of automotive production and battery manufacturing. This site is getting this much attention because the UK government is committed to supporting battery and electric car production in the UK over the next several years. In this factory, it is hoped that it will be possible to recruit global leaders in advanced manufacturing, robotics, artificial intelligence, and electric cars. The Bridgewater site is one of only a few in the UK capable of hosting a gigafactory, and the massive 635-acre area seems to be an appealing future base for Tesla. According to experts, locating a Tesla plant in a country with a right-hand drive system would be a wise decision for the organization. It speeds up growth and expansion to satisfy the demand for electrochemical energy storage technology and skills production, predicts that Britain will require 1 gigafactory by 2022, 2 gigafactories by 2025, and 8 gigafactories by 2040. Some critics have then pointed out that a gigafactory in the UK may not be necessary. This is because at the moment, there are limited sales of UK-made electric vehicles to date, and UK-based manufacturers have not gone as far in accepting the technology like the way General Motors have, which recently declared its intention to market only zero-emission cars and trucks by 2035. There is no excuse for constructing a factory unless there is more interest. Ian Henry, the head of forecasting and data department auto analysis, agreed that there isn't so much of a need for cars to have such a large amount of batteries just yet. Jaguar's Land Rover announced earlier this week that it would turn to battery power for all its versions. If the government needs to provide enough batteries for vehicles, it must collaborate with Jaguar, Nissan, and others to persuade the automotive company's chosen suppliers to establish a factory. Henry added that the UK does not already benefit from Scandinavia, which has one of the fastest electric vehicle penetration rates in the country, rendering it an attractive place for investment. Neither is the UK like France or Germany. They have home-run automotive makers that are more willing to spend in their home country than elsewhere, as all of the UK's big factories are run by international manufacturers. Now that the UK's long-term trade partnership with the EU has been established, investors will possibly take a second look at the nation, and these identified challenges may not pose a problem to the company. Britain's got all the necessary ingredients for growth, as they are Europe's fourth largest automotive manufacturer. Tesla is currently conducting cutting-edge research and constructing a scale-up facility. The government is touting support for a green industrial revolution, pledging almost £500 million over the next 4 years for mass-scale battery manufacturing. One big issue for industries in the UK and EU, however, is that essential battery metals, including lithium, cobalt, and nickel, are mined elsewhere. Chinese firms, which manufacture half of the world's electric cars, also own more than half of the cobalt generated in the Democratic Republic of the Congo, which is needed for most lithium-ion batteries. Furthermore, China has more than half the world's lithium mining potential. Making an electric vehicle without China's participation is quite complicated. Everyone is looking to reduce their dependence on China, and policymakers are very concerned about the possibility of possible export tariffs. The pandemic has focused minds ever more on the challenge of reducing reliance on global supplies to ensure raw material entry. EU countries such as Finland and Portugal are proposing mining their supplies, and this is all about the rising strategic autonomy over the demand. Beijing's supply chain domination is unlikely to wane significantly over the next decade, and several firms in the UK are exploring the possibility of accessing underground lithium reserves. Cornish Lithium is still searching for lithium in Cornwall's hot springs. British Lithium is a competing effort, also recently received a grant to finance discovery further to make low-carbon technologies. "We need to extract more raw materials than we did in the past," says Lucy Crane, a senior geologist at Cornish Lithium. "We have a not-in-my-backyard mentality. For decades, we have outsourced our issues to other areas of the planet. Lithium mining in Chile's Atacama Desert, for instance, can be refined in China or Korea before being sent to European ports using cars. That is a lot of carbon footprint." To accelerate the commercialization of advanced battery research, the UK government invests £130 million in a battery industrialization center in Coventry. It is built to be a center that hopefully becomes the missing link between promising innovations and mass manufacturing performance. Any organization with the current or latest battery technologies will be able to use the center quickly. The expectation is that it will entice major producers to be located nearby and collaborate on research and development projects. It is predicted that the test site will help hold the UK at the forefront of emerging battery technology. "Having the technology is one thing, and constructing large-scale industrial plans is quite another. This is one other thing that is being considered for the Gravity site, and what it would take to build." The Low Carbon Industrial Park in Somerset, which covers over 600 acres on the site of a former Royal Ordnance factory, has been proposed as the ideal future home for the massive facility. Tesla selected a venue outside Britain, Germany, for its first European factory last year, rather than a plant located in northeast England. Musk said that the company preferred Brandenburg over Tees Valley because of the Brexit confusion. However, after some problems with the building of a Gigafactory near Berlin, the mayors of Tees Valley then wrote to Tesla CEO Elon Musk, urging him to reconsider. "If Tesla decides to open another overseas plant, the UK will face intense competition. A major one will be from India, where Transport Minister Nitin Gadkari recently said that the country is prepared to give significant concessions to guarantee that production costs are even lower than those at Tesla's Gigafactory, Shanghai, and China. In addition to the plans for the new site, Tesla submitted a document to become an energy supplier in the UK. In its application to the UK's Gas and Electricity Markets Authority, Tesla requested a license that would allow it to generate electricity to supply any premises in Britain. Elon Musk previously stated that Tesla Energy could be as large or even more extensive than the car sector of the company. In addition, Prime Minister Boris Johnson will likely be eager after he outlined his 10-point plan for a green industrial revolution. Mr. Johnson set out his ambitious proposals to create and support up to 250,000 British jobs. Covering clean energy, transport, nature, and innovative technologies, the Prime Minister's blueprint will allow the UK to meet its net zero commitment by 2050. What do you think about this Gigafactory? Do you think it will boost a lot of production for Tesla? Thank you for watching this video. While you're still here, go ahead and click on one of these videos on your screen right now for more awesome content waiting for you. See you there!